Doing a sum if in Google Sheets is pretty simple, but things get tricky when you need to work with multiple criteria. By the end of this video, you'll have the skills to create a formula like this. One that works with multiple conditions, like the two criteria we'll use in this example, and gives you accurate results in seconds. Hi, welcome to Productivity Land, the channel where you learn Google Sheets without dying of boredom. Today, I'm going to teach you how to sum values based on multiple criteria. The best way to learn is by doing, so if you want to follow along, I've included a link to the spreadsheet I'll be using in the video description. Let's dive in. Imagine you're running an online business selling denim jackets for dogs, and you're paying for ads on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and Google. Sales are going well, but you want your brand to become the go-to denim jacket for dogs. To do that, you need to figure out which social media platform brought you the most profit last year so you can invest more money there and grow faster. In this Google Sheets file, you have data showing how much you spent on each platform, the revenue each generated, and when those transactions happened, including the year and the month. On the right, there's a small table where you want to summarize this information for analysis. How would you do it? If you're new to spreadsheets, this might feel like a nightmare. If you know a bit more, you could filter for Facebook, filter the year, sum the revenue, and copy-paste it into the table. But let's be honest, that's not very efficient. An expert would use a function to get it done in seconds. Instead of using SUMIF, we're going to use its big brother, SUMIFS. The difference is that SUMIF lets you sum based on one condition, while SUMIFS allows you to sum based on multiple criteria at the same time. For example, in this case, we'll tell Google Sheets to sum the revenue if the platform is Facebook and the year is 2024. Two criteria. Let me show you how. The first thing you need to do is define named ranges. This step is optional, but it's a super handy trick that makes building your formula 1,000 times easier. Here's how it works. Select the range of cells you want to name, go to the name box at the top, type in the name you want, and hit enter. For this example, we'll call it platform. While you're at it, go ahead and define ranges for year. Spending and revenue. Pro tip, don't forget to hit enter after naming the range, or Google Sheets won't save it. Now that we've got that set up, let's move on to SUMIFS. In a cell, type equals SUMIFS. The first thing it asks for is the range you want to sum. In this case, we want the revenue, so type revenue. Since we used a named range, it automatically selects the entire column. Easy, right? Next, it asks for the ranges and criteria. That's where you set the conditions for summing the revenue. The first condition is that the platform should be Facebook. So type platform to refer to the named range, add a comma, and then select the cell with Facebook. If you want to add another condition, just type a comma and repeat the process. In this case, we'll also add a condition for the year. Type year to refer to the named range, add a comma, and then specify 2024 as the criteria. Since you'll be using the same year for all platforms, you can lock the cell reference with F4, so you can drag the formula down to other rows. And that's it! You've got your result! Now, to wrap it up, if you also want to calculate spending instead of revenue, you don't need to start from scratch. Just copy the formula you already created and paste it into the cell where you want to calculate spending. Then, replace revenue with spending in the formula. This tells Google Sheets to sum the spending column instead of revenue. Once it's set, drag the formula down to fill the rest of the table. Simple, right? Finally, YouTube thinks this next video is the secret sauce to becoming a Google Sheets wizard. Click it, or you might end up stuck with manual calculations forever. See you there!